Today we're talking about how to fix and relink offline media in Adobe Premiere Pro. And that starts right now. Hello friends and family, Ryan here from RyanCampFilms.com. Thanks so much for being here today. Today I have a quick Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial for you guys. If you've been using Adobe Premiere Pro for any amount of time, chances are you've ran across this screen right here. And it can look pretty scary if you're not sure what exactly is happening. But today I'll go over how we can easily fix this error and prevent it in the future. I'll be covering some bonus organizational tips at the end of the video as well if you're interested in that aspect. And I will be sharing how you can stay more organized as it pertains to your Adobe projects and prevent issues like offline media happening in the future. Adobe Premiere keeps track of your project's files by remembering the file paths that point to your files on your computer's storage drives. When this media offline error appears, it means that Adobe cannot locate your file that was previously used. This occurs because either the file path has been changed somehow, like a file name has been changed, the actual file has been moved to a new location, or the file has been deleted from its previous location. If the file has been deleted and you don't have a backup file anywhere to point to, there's not much that can be done. But let's take a look at an example of a file path change and we'll see how it can easily be fixed. First, let's pull up and open a project file from a folder here in Premiere. I'll go back and change the name of either the main folder and the files that exist in it, or the actual file name itself. If I go back and change the name of either the main folder that the file exists in, or the actual file name itself, we will get the media offline error here within Adobe Premiere. Adobe no longer knows where that file is and where it can be located because the file path has changed. When Adobe notices that the files aren't linking, it will automatically pull up the link media window to help you sort things out. If you need to pull up the link media window manually, just right-click on the file that has missing media on your timeline, it's usually colored red by default, and select link media. Within the link media window, just select the file that you are looking to relink from the list and then click locate. Once the locate window pops up, it will show you the previous location of the file and let you browse your computer for where the file might be located presently. If you know where the file is, this is simple. Just click the file in the search window and then click OK. The relink is now complete. But if you have to search for it, you can use Display Only Exact Name Matches. Click that little checkbox if the file has been moved and not renamed, or you can type the new name of the file, if you know it, in the search bar to try and locate it. Other than that, you may have to do some manual digging to find your file, either by close approximation of the name or go by the preview image if you know what the file should look like. Once you find the file and click OK, that's it. That's all there is to it. See, media offline error doesn't have to be as scary as it looks, but it can be an avoidable nuisance. If you've watched this video this far, thank you so much. Do me a favor and post the word offline in the comments below so I can see who's been paying attention. And now for some bonus organizational tips. Organization, in my opinion, is one of the most important things we can do for any sort of endeavor or work, whether it's organizing files on your computer or your gear that you have strewn everywhere in your gear closet or gear bag. It just makes things flow better, keeps us in a good frame of mind, and helps the job get done more efficiently and save some time in the process. The key is to be organized inside of Premiere and outside of Premiere using the same naming conventions and folder locations so we can find everything easily. So next time you're going to start a new video project for Premiere, create a folder on your desktop or external hard drive or wherever you want to keep your video project stored. For the sake of this example, we will just name this folder set New Project. Now within the project folder, we will create subfolders. I typically create the subfolders Video, Audio, Music, Graphics, Exports, Sequences, and Project Files. Once you have all of your folders named and ready, just create a new project within Premiere, use a naming convention that makes sense for your workflow, and save the project within the project files subfolder within your new project main folder. Now just drag and drop all of your new folders into the project window in Adobe Premiere. That's just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to organization for your projects in Adobe. For further customization, you can right-click on each folder's color label within Adobe and customize the color within the label menu. You can also group folders together here if you'd like. For better organization, pick a file naming convention that helps you keep things organized as well. Use numbers or dates to help tell different versions of your files apart, and save different versions of your files with different names as you work so you can revisit a previous version of that file if you need to. And there you have it, guys. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you have any additional tips for linking offline media or project organization, please share them in the comments below. Thanks for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.